In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the Most Compassionate. O Prophet, fear Allah and do not obey the unbelievers and the hypocrites. Verily, Allah is all-knowing, most wise. Follow that which is revealed to you from your Lord. Verily, Allah is fully aware of all that you do. Put your trust in Allah. Allah is sufficient as guardian. Allah has never put two hearts within one person's body, nor has He made your wives, whom you compare to your mother's backs, to divorce them, your true mothers, nor has He made those whom you adopt as sons, your own sons. These are only words that you utter with your mouths. But Allah proclaims the truth and directs you to the right path. Call your adopted sons after their true fathers. That is more equitable in the sight of Allah. But if you do not know their true fathers, then regard them as your brethren in faith and as allies. You will not be taken to task for your mistaken utterances, but you will be taken to task for what you say deliberately. Allah is most forgiving, most compassionate. Surely, the Prophet has a greater claim over the believers than they have over each other, and his wives are their mothers. According to the Book of Allah, blood relatives have greater claim over each other than the rest of the believers and the emigrants in the cause of Allah, except that you may do some good to your allies if you so wish. This is inscribed in the Book of Allah. And call to mind, O Prophet, when we took the covenant from all prophets and also from you and Noah and Abraham, Moses and Jesus, the son of Mary. Peace be upon them. We took from them a solemn covenant, so that their Lord may question the truthful about their truthfulness. As for the unbelievers, He has kept a painful chastisement in store for them. Believers, call to mind Allah's favor to you. When enemy hosts invaded you, then we sent against them a wind and hosts that you did not see, although Allah was observing all that you were then doing. When they came upon you from above you and from below you, when your eyes were stupefied with horror and your hearts leapt to your throats, and you began to entertain diverse thoughts about Allah. The believers were then put to a severe test and were most violently convulsed. And call to mind when the hypocrites and all those with diseased hearts said, all that Allah and His Messenger had promised us was nothing but deceit. And when a section of them said, O people of Yathrib, now there is no place for you to stay, so turn back. And call to mind when a section of them was seeking permission from the Prophet to leave, saying, our houses are exposed to attack, although they were not exposed to attack. They only wished to flee from the battlefront. If the enemy were to enter the town from various directions, and they were summoned to act treacherously, they would have succumbed to it and would have shown little reluctance in doing so. They had earlier covenanted with Allah that they would not turn their backs in flight, and a covenant made with Allah must needs be answered for. O Prophet, tell them, if you run away from death or slaying, this flight will not avail you. You have little time after that to enjoy the pleasures of life. Say to them, who can protect you from Allah if He desires an evil for you? And who can prevent Him if He desires to show mercy to you? They shall find none other than Allah to be their protector or helper. Allah knows well those of you who create obstructions in war efforts, and say to their brethren, come and join us. They hardly take any part in battle. They are utterly niggardly in coming to your aid. Whenever there is danger, you will see them looking at you, their eyes rolling as though they were on the verge of fainting at the approach of death. But when the danger passes away, their greed for wealth prompts them to greet you with their sharp, scissor-like tongues. These are the ones who never truly believed, and so Allah has caused their deeds to be reduced to naught. That is easy enough for Allah. They think that the invading confederates have not yet gone, but if the confederates were to mount another assault, they would wish to be in the desert among the Bedouins and keep themselves informed about you from there. But even if they remained in your midst, hardly would they fight. Surely, there was a good example for you in the Messenger of Allah, for those who look forward to Allah and the Last Day and remember Allah much. As for the true believers, when they saw the invading confederates, they cried out, "This is what Allah and His Messenger had promised us, and what Allah and His Messenger said was absolutely true." This only increased their faith and submission. Among the believers, there are those who have remained true to the covenant they made with Allah. Among those, some of them have fulfilled their vow, and others await the appointed time. They have not changed in the least. All this is in order that Allah may reward the truthful for their truthfulness, and either punish the hypocrites, or, if He so wills, accept their repentance. Verily, Allah is most pardoning, most compassionate. Allah sent back the unbelievers empty-handed, their hearts seething with rage. Allah sufficed the believers in their fight. Allah is most powerful, most mighty. Allah brought down from their fortresses those people of the book who had supported the invading confederates and cast such terror into their hearts that some of them you kill and some of them you take captive. Allah made you inherit their land, their dwellings, and their goods, and a piece of land on which you had not yet trodden. Verily, Allah has power over all things. O Prophet, tell your wives, if you seek the world and its embellishments, then come, and I will make some provision for you and release you in an honorable way. But if you seek Allah and His Messenger and the abode of the hereafter, then surely Allah has prepared a great reward for those of you who do good. Wives of the Prophet, if any of you commit flagrant indecency, her chastisement shall be doubled. That is easy for Allah. But whoever of you is obedient to Allah and His Messenger and does good deeds, Allah will double her reward. We have prepared for her a generous provision. Wives of the Prophet, you are not like other women. If you fear Allah, do not be too complacent in your speech, lest those with diseased hearts should covet you, but speak in a straightforward manner. And stay in your homes, and do not go about displaying your allurements as in the former time of ignorance. Establish prayer, give zakah, and obey Allah and His Messenger. Allah only wishes to remove uncleanness from you, O members of the Prophet's household, and to purify you completely. Remember the signs of Allah and the words of wisdom which are rehearsed in your homes. Verily, Allah is all subtle, all aware. Surely, the men who submit to Allah and the women who submit to Allah, the men who have faith and the women who have faith, the men who are obedient and the women who are obedient, the men who are truthful and the women who are truthful, the men who are steadfast and the women who are steadfast, the men who humble themselves to Allah and the women who humble themselves to Allah, the men who give alms and the women who give alms, the men who fast and the women who fast, the men who guard their chastity and the women who guard their chastity, the men who remember Allah much and the women who remember Allah much. For them has Allah prepared forgiveness and a mighty reward. It does not behove a believer, male or female, that when Allah and His Messenger have decided an affair, they should exercise their choice. And whoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger has strayed to manifest error. O Prophet, call to mind when you said to him, whom Allah had favored and you had favored, "Cleave to your wife and fear Allah." And you concealed within yourself for fear of people what Allah was to reveal, although Allah has greater right that you fear Him. So when Zaid had accomplished what he would of her, we gave her in marriage to you, so that there should not be any constraint for the believers regarding the wives of their adopted sons after they had accomplished whatever they would of them. And Allah's command was bound to be accomplished. There would be no hindrance to the Prophet regarding what Allah ordained for him. Such has been Allah's way with the prophets who went before. Allah's command is a decree firmly determined. This is Allah's way regarding those who deliver the messages of Allah and who fear Him and fear no one else than Allah. Allah is sufficient as a reckoner. Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the father of any of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah and the seal of the prophets. Allah has full knowledge of everything. Believers, remember Allah much and glorify Him morning and evening. It is He who lavishes His blessings on you, and His angels invoke blessings on you, that He may lead you out of darkness into light. He is most compassionate to the believers. On the day they meet Him, they will be greeted with peace. He has prepared for them a generous reward. O Prophet, we have sent you forth as a witness, a bearer of good tidings, and a warner, as one who calls people to Allah by His leave, and as a bright shining lamp. Announce to the believers the good tidings that Allah has kept bounteous blessings in store for them. Do not yield to the unbelievers and the hypocrites, and disregard the hurt that comes from them, and put your trust in Allah. Allah suffices as the guardian to entrust one's affairs to. Believers, when you marry believing women and then divorce them before you have touched them, you may not require them to observe a waiting period that you might reckon against them. So make provision for them and release them in an honorable manner. O Prophet, we have made lawful for you your wives whose bridal dues you have paid, and the slave girls you possess from among the prisoners of war, granted to you by Allah, and the daughters of your paternal uncles and paternal aunts, and the daughters of your maternal uncles and maternal aunts who have migrated with you, and a believing woman who gives herself to the Prophet and whom he wants to take in marriage. O Prophet, this privilege is yours alone to the exclusion of other believers. We know well what restrictions we have imposed upon them as regards their wives and those whom their right hands possess, and have exempted you from those restrictions, that there may be no constraint upon you. Allah is most forgiving, most merciful. Of them, you may put off any of them you wish, and you may take any of them whom you wish, and you may call back any of those whom you had temporarily set aside. There will be no blame on you on this account. It is likelier that they will thus be comforted and will not grieve, and every one of them will be well pleased with what you give them. Allah knows what is in your hearts. Allah is all-knowing, all-forbearing. Thereafter, women will not be lawful for you, and it will not be lawful for you to take other wives in place of them, even though their beauty might please you, unless they be those whom your right hand owns. Allah is watchful over everything. Believers, enter not the houses of the Prophet without his permission, nor wait for a meal to be prepared. Instead, enter when you are invited to eat, and when you have had the meal, disperse. Do not linger in idle talk. That is hurtful to the Prophet, but he does not express it out of shyness. But Allah is not ashamed of speaking out the truth. And if you were to ask the wives of the Prophet for something, ask from behind a curtain. That is more apt for the cleanness of your hearts and theirs. It is not lawful for you to cause hurt to Allah's Messenger, nor to ever marry his wives after him. Surely, that would be an enormous sin in Allah's sight. It does not matter whether you disclose something or conceal it, for Allah certainly knows everything. It will not be blameworthy for the wives of the Prophet if their fathers, their sons, their brothers' sons, their sisters' sons, and the women with whom they have social relations, and the persons whom their right hands possess enter their houses. O women, shun disobeying Allah. Allah is watchful over everything. Allah and His angels bless the Prophet. Believers, invoke blessings and peace on him. Verily, those who cause annoyance to Allah and His Messenger, Allah has cursed them in this world and in the hereafter, and has prepared for them a humiliating chastisement. Those who cause hurt to believing men and to believing women have invited upon themselves a calumny and a manifest sin. O Prophet, enjoin your wives and your daughters and the believing women to draw a part of their outer coverings around them. It is likelier that they will be recognized and not molested. Allah is most forgiving, most merciful. If the hypocrites and those in whose hearts there is a sickness and the scandalmongers in Medina do not desist from their vile acts, we shall urge you to take action against them. And then they will hardly be able to stay in the city with you. They shall be cursed from all around, and they shall be ruthlessly killed wherever they are seized. This has been Allah's way with those who have gone before, and you shall find no change in Allah's way. People ask you concerning the hour of resurrection. Say, Allah alone has knowledge of it. What do you know? Perhaps the hour is nigh. Allah has cursed the unbelievers and has prepared for them a blazing fire. Therein they shall abide forever. They shall find none to protect or help them. On that day, when their faces shall be turned around in the fire, they will say, "With that we had obeyed Allah and obeyed the Messenger." They will say, "Our Lord, we obeyed our chiefs and our great ones, and they turned us away from the right way. Our Lord, mete out to them a double chastisement and lay upon them a mighty curse." Believers, do not be like those who distressed Moses, peace be upon him, and then Allah declared him quit of the ill they spoke about him, and he had a high standing with Allah. Believers, fear Allah and speak the truth. Allah will set your deeds right for you and will forgive you your sins. Whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved a great triumph. We offered the trust to the heavens and the earth and the mountains, but they refused to carry it and were afraid of doing so. But man carried it. Surely he is wrongdoing, ignorant. The consequence of man's carrying the trust is that Allah may chastise hypocritical men and hypocritical women and accept the repentance of believing men and believing women. He is most forgiving, most merciful.